having the Philadelphia chromosome identifies a child as having a higher risk of a relapse. And the reason they have a higher risk is they, in their body, they have a protein that shouldn't be there. And it's the result of the Philadelphia chromosome that they have that protein. That protein is like a switch. And just like a light switch, it should be able to be turned on and turned off. When you have the Philadelphia chromosome, the switch is turned on, but it won't turn off. So this protein is signaling to the cell that it should divide and divide and divide. And when cells divide in an uncontrolled way, that causes cancer. Back in 2000, the cure rate for Philadelphia positive acute lymphoblastic leukemia in children was about 20%. There have been a series of clinical trials run by the Children's Oncology Group to try to better the cure rates in this group of patients. The first trial used a drug called imatinib, which was a drug that targeted the protein that's abnormal in the leukemic cells. And when we added imatinib to the chemotherapy backbone, the cure rate improved to be about 70% at 3 years. The cure rate with a bone marrow transplant in this group of patients was about 60%. As a result of that trial, people started to wonder, can we replace the transplant with chemotherapy plus imatinib? And we then ran a second trial, and that's the trial that's been published recently based on the work that I was the chair of this trial. And this trial used a drug called dasatinib. Compared to the previous trial where we used imatinib, all those patients received radiation therapy to their brain. In the subsequent trial that I chaired, we did not use radiation. And the radiation can cause problems with learning, and it can cause kids to develop brain tumors later. So dropping radiation was an important goal. So the result of the trial was interesting. It seemed early on that the patients did better on this trial, and the early responses were better than when we used imatinib. But as time went on, it seemed like the longer term response rates were very similar, but not necessarily better. We're trying to figure out how to hit the sweet spot of giving them just enough chemotherapy to cure them, but sort of avoid having the side effects of the chemotherapy. Ultimately, it would be nice to have several targeted drugs like imatinib or dasatinib that could be used and completely eliminate the use of the traditional chemo that is so toxic to people's bodies. An important part of this story is the fact that we're now curing 90%, not more than 90% of the children with acute lymphoblastic leukemia. But in order to really declare victory, we want to cure all of these kids. So how do we identify the children who are not going to be cured? Well, one of the groups that we know has a higher risk of not being cured is these patients with the Philadelphia chromosome. And so by focusing our efforts on developing better treatments for this group of patients, we're closing the gap, and we're working towards making the number of kids who relapse get smaller and smaller, to the point where no kid relapses in the future. That's our goal.